Thank you. Okay. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Now, it's strange enough that video games have actually, well, turned into movies. Like you have Super Mario Brothers, Street Fighter, but now they've actually taken the music from the video games and put them on CD, really, for your enjoyment. And, well, one of them they've done it to is Donkey Kong Country. And here, why don't you take a listen to Donkey Kong Country, Fred, if you get a shot of the game, and enjoy.
Check it.
Okay, that was a quick listen.
There
we go.
See, here's my wife coming out here.
That's her. Where am I?
As you can tell, rockers have got a lot of time off.
There you go.
To learn Donkey Kong.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now that's a lot of fun, as I'm sure you can tell. Maybe something good to dance to, who knows? And I guess it kind of makes sense because Donkey Kong Country was the number one selling video game last year, so they've put it on CD. But what's even stranger is that there's a Mortal Kombat CD, and this would be Mortal Kombat right here. And what the folks at Mortal Kombat did was they went out and they hired a techno group called the Immortals. And, well, Mortal Kombat is a game that doesn't really feature music, it really features violence. So they took the violence and mixed it with techno. And here, take a listen. Let me pop in here. Okay, there you have it. Are you feeling violent, folks? Okay. Those are two CDs for you, Donkey Kong Country and Mortal Kombat. And if you're addicted to the video games, I don't know, maybe this is a way, as Sebastian is, you know, this might be a way to wean you off video games. Who knows, Jeff, those are a couple CDs out there for you.
To the band and back.
Okay, I'm just wondering.
Delphi, it's soundeffects@delphi.com. That's how to get a hold of us. We love having your questions. Karen Bryant is now in the rec room with a band called Skid Row.
Thanks, Jeff. Yes, I'm in heaven. I'm amongst Skid Row. I'm totally psyched. I guess first we should just go down and do the intros. We've got Rachel, Scott, Rob, Baz, and Snake. And they rock. Guys, thank you for coming. I mean, this is huge.
Thank you.
Silly, excellent. So this is the deal. The first time I actually saw Skid Row play, you guys were opening up for Aerosmith. Okay, now, over the years, what would you say has changed about Skid Row and Skid Row's audience?
When we first came out, MTV played a lot of hard rock.
Yeah.
And, you know, I kind of got sick of myself because we were on TV every 20 seconds.
Right, 18 and life.
Yeah, and I Remember You and all that.
Right.
But that was like, you know, 7 years ago. And since then, we put out two and a half records since then. We did Slave to the Grind,
right,
and Beside Ourselves and Subhuman Race.
Right.
And so it's more now, I think, music is taken to the forefront in the 90s instead of a lot of image and mm-hmm. videos and stuff.
Cool.
So like that's why I think a show like this is a lot cooler than, you know, just a video show, because you get
excellent.
The real deal right
thank
in
you.
Your face. What do you guys think?
Yes. Yes, we totally agree. Now, the thing that's great is your sound has really, really evolved. I mean, I think the songwriting has really come a long way. Your voice has come a long way. What was different about recording this record?
You're a different country.
Yeah.
I mean, this record was, it took a while to do, but when it came down to actually recording it, it seemed like everything happened overnight.
Oh, he needs to put his head there. I'm sorry.
I thought I had one.
What I said was, oh, now I got to repeat myself. What was I saying?
Of all our records.
Oh yeah, out of all of our records, this is one of them. No, it. We just did everything different.
Yeah.
Right from the songwriting, we wanted to get away from what we did in the past, and from recording, we did it with Bob Rock, and mm-hmm. he did things completely the opposite of what we were used to. So everything was kind of experimental, mm-hmm. touch and go type of thing.
Well, I think it came out amazing. It's just really an amazing record. What I think that's great about this record too is, you know, I know when people go, oh, geez, Skid Row, is it hard rock or is it metal? Like, is it okay to like them if I also like this group? How do you guys feel about, you know, kind of crossing the genres of what the music is?
Well, I kind of miss the 70s when you could like go see Kiss with Bob Seger, with Emerson, Lake and Palmer, with Nana Muscuri, all in the same bill, you know? I mean, I think that there's more of that now, starting to get a little bit better, but there was a real like prejudicial time for a little while there.
Yeah.
But like last tour we had Pantera for a couple months and Soundgarden for a couple months, mm-hmm. and this year we're well, I can't tell you who we're taking it because it's not confirmed, but but we start our tour on May 6th down in Tampa, and we go all through America till middle of June, then we go to Japan, then we come back and we do all festivals. Like outdoor places in America all through the summer.
Excellent. Well, we're going to look forward to that, and we'll wait for the announcement, and we'll announce the band that's opening for you. But now, it's time for you guys to be Skid Rock again. And I'm telling you, what are we going to hear this time?
This is a song right now that is doing really well on the radio across America. It's called Into Another.
All right.
Into yet another song.
Skid Row, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's do the box.
I'm too wound up.
the album Subhuman Race, everybody needs to pick it up. It's wonderful. You do hardcore, you do belly, you just, it rocks. Ladies and gentlemen, Skid Row, thank you.
Thanks, Sarah.
Thank you, guys.
Still to come on Sound FX, Afshin, Electronic Dance Music, and more from Skid Row. We'll be right back.
You're going to play us a final number.
Yes.
And we've arranged something that I hope it's okay with you. We brought in a band to kind of back you up, I guess, and I hope you don't mind.
No.
All right, I'll take this from
okay,
you.
Okay, thanks.
And you want to work, there's a little band called Skid Row.
Oh, wait,
and,
I'll tell you what.
You want to play a little one? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And I told them to be real quiet and not to overshadow you.
Okay.
And I'm going to turn the bass down just a little bit. So. All right, this is our first. Robert Good. Dick
cool.
and Skid Row. I didn't get to mention, Robert Dick has an album out with a lot of Hendrix. It's a Hendrix tribute. It's called Third Stone from the Sun. And our thanks to everybody. Afshin for bringing DB and Danny. And where's our third? He left?
He had to
leave.
And remember, go to the dump.
Yeah, and get some stuff.
And come and see the fire fishers.
Excellent, excellent. Of course, we have to thank Skid Row. The album is called Subhuman Race. It rocks from A to Z. We got the Fugees on Monday.
And Robert Dick's going to sit in again on this song.
Excellent. All right, Skid Row, please take it out. Thank you.
Jesus, he knows the story. He knows the position that I'm in. A hooker knows the feeling. Do you fuck me up here? Tonight, inside him, your man drank my water. You look at me like I'm some human again. Talk to me like I'm some human again. Treat me like I'm some human again. I'm jumping into the some human race.